Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're here in Bolton today for the Sexton versus Huey Fury British title fight. But right now we've got Reece Cartwright with us. We're just coming off a great win. Firstly, I've been told, firstly, congratulations, Reece. We're told to start with you, Keith. Firstly, can you assess your man's performance in there tonight?
Yeah, we're very calm and composed. Once he got the first round out of the way and the nerves, you know, he stuck behind his jab, boxed well, and then it was just a matter of time, really.
Yeah.
He was picking his shots a lot better today. So he's improving all the time.
Well, it was a peach of a shot that you finished the fight with, Reece, that left up to the body.
Yeah.
Is that something you have been working on with Rick and Keith in the gym?
We only knew about the opponent from Thursday, so I couldn't really practice shots and stuff, but it's something we've been learning through camp in general. We've just been learning everything, you know, all around. But so yeah, it's, you know, it fell in nicely.
Yeah. And Rick, I could see this week you've been buzzing with pride and, you know, sort of everything that Reece has got this last minute sort of shot, so to speak. Can you just give us your thoughts and how happy you are today?
I'm quite happy with the performance, and I'm quite happy with how the camp went. Again, you're talking about this guy was a dangerous guy. You're talking about he knocked out his last, seven people. You're talking about, at the end of the day, told Reece, we've got to take this and we've got to break this guy down. Obviously, Reece is like a sponge here. We will learn and he'll do as you're told, like a robot, but a fantastic robot, fantastic engine, good fitness, you're talking about, and I'm very happy with the performance, very proud of it.
Brilliant.
And that's the best I've ever heard you say.
You know what? I was going to say, you got
shot.
I'm getting emotional over it. Reece, now looking at your opponent's body, I didn't expect it to be a body shot that finished him. He looked coming in good shape.
Do you know what though? I kept coming back to my corner, and the round before the stoppage, when I come back to the corner, Keith said to me, listen, you don't like them body shots. Mm. So he said, you got to fake him upstairs and throw the body shot, and that's what took him out of it.
Yeah.
So just glad I got it in there.
Keith, what's Reece like to sort of work with? What's his work ethic like? Tell us a little bit about that side of things.
His work ethic is second to none, really. He's a very diligent character, and whatever you do, whatever you ask him to do, he will do.
Mm.
But you know, you can't wish for a better lad to train than Reece, really. You know, whatever he lacks in ability, he more than makes up for in effort. You know, he'll tell you himself. Sometimes it might take him twice as long as maybe Zaya to learn something, but he will work and work and graft and graft and graft and graft until he can get it. And people can relate to that. Working class people can relate to a working class lad working hard at his craft and dedicating himself.
That's a good point you make there, Keith. And Reece, in the build up to this fight, I know you was sparring with some heavyweights as well. And obviously, you know, if you can spar with heavyweights, you can spar with anyone, and getting in the ring, you know, it's never easy. But is that something you might feature again in another camp?
Do you know what? It's camp, innit, and you know, you have to take sparring as you can get it, and if you can only get sparring with heavyweights, you've got to mix it with heavyweights. If you can get it with bantamweights, I'll get in there with a bantamweight and just move around and, you know, make him miss, and you got to take what you can get, really, and if you can get sparring with heavyweights, I'll take it.
Yeah.
Peter Fury has been instrumental in helping the sparring along. You're talking about when you go down Fury's Champions Gym, you're talking about it's like the Lion's Den. He don't mess about. He don't want no nonsense. You go down there and you work hard, and that's all there is to it. And Reece, basically, you're talking about, he's took to it. And at the end of the day, we thank Peter Fury and the Fury camp and Mick Hennessy for letting this happen, because at the end of the day, you're talking about, without them guys, he wouldn't have had his shot today, and you're talking about, and now a lot of people can see him. They heard, a lot of people have heard about him, but a lot of people can see him. So that's fine for me and fantastic.
Mm. I've seen you guys as a team sparring in all different sorts of gyms. I mean, last time I saw you sparring was in Manchester, actually. I mean, you guys are on the road for sparring as well, aren't you? You're not afraid to go anywhere.
We've got to travel. People don't like travelling, and you know, the best fighters we know over Manchester, Liverpool, they're all over the place, so you got to travel for it, and it makes it all better. You're going to have to send me this interview, because I've had good words from both of these.
Do you know,
I've never had that before.
Yeah.
You're going to have to send me this interview. Before we go, can I thank David and Jeremy from Bauer Group?
Yeah.
I'd like to thank Abigail Roofing and Mick Hennessy and Peter Fury for all the work they've put into me in the past few weeks.
Yeah, brilliant. Well, listen, congratulations, Reece. Great performance on a great platform. Gentlemen, thanks for your time. Appreciate it.
Nice
Aki Kareem, British Boxers, you know the score. Awa.
Thanks, Aki.